Hello, dearest friends of the internet. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. Welcome back. It's Banjo-Tooie time. Let's do some fun. Well, let's have fun in the sun. We're inside. No vitamin D for us today. We don't get the D on this episode. Well, somebody might get the D. I do have a Globo. You can have it. This transformation is incredibly iconic. This transformation is so iconic because this transformation is technically in the first game. It's useless, and it's only a transformation that you get once in a blue moon from Mumbo at random, and then he immediately transforms you back. Wumba called this washer. Use left stick to move. Press LT or RT to fire plenty underwear. Ooh. Have my undies! They're clean! I don't think Wumba was expecting that, honestly. So yeah, they've made a fully fledged washing machine transformation in Banjo-Tooie. Like, think about my surprise when this happened, knowing full well that the washing machine was something that you could get in the first game, technically. I even have a video series on this channel. Ah! Oh, I was supposed to Mumbo first! Shite! I thought I had it backwards, dude. I was like, oh man, surely I do. Oh no. This was all on purpose to show you the giant electromagnet. This is all done on purpose, I swear to God. Okay, hold on. False alarm. We have to go to Mumbo. I was in the right place at the beginning. I had it in my head when I started, I was like, I think I have to transform and hit the button first. Because my thought was that you hit the button and then the electromagnet. In hindsight, it's stupid that I thought that. Because there's a giant magnet that pulls you away from it. So, in hindsight, it all makes sense. But my memory was just like, which order do I do this in? Mumbo, please show me your sack. I've got small creature. I want your help. I need you to stop the magnet from existing, please.
Woo!
I think that's one of my favorite things about the Rare games of this era. A lot of them had like not like the same exact sound effect, but similar sound effects across the games. Like there's a lot of games that came around the same time, like DK64. There's a lot of the voices. Oh, banana. You know, like that kind of voice is very iconic to me. I guess that's the theme of today's episode. How iconic is Banjo-Kazooie? All right, Mumbo, do your thing. Hope this works. It has every other time you've used it. Magnet malfunction, auto fixing program initiated. Magnet will be reactivated in 90 seconds. All right, we're gonna sprint. Let's go. Faster, Mumbo, faster. Speed run that shit. Let's go. World record pace. Pick it up, Mumbo. Your stubby little legs need to carry you faster. It's okay, we have warps. So easy. So easy with warps. Tell you what. Honestly, it almost like the warping sort of almost makes the elevator shaft pointless besides like one specific thing that you have to use the elevator shaft for where there's no warp to a particular floor. But like, there's almost no reason to ever use the elevator shaft to get around this world. I guess it does help connect it in your mind a little bit better though, I think. Okay, now we can transform. Listen, this was all a ploy to show you that the electromagnet magnet does a thing. actually does do a thing and you can't do it. Ah! Ah! Idiot! Moron! Freaking loser! Don't mind me, I'm just berating a inanimate object. There we go. There we go. So that was the series of events that we needed to do to unlock the boss area. So I think we will immediately go do that right now. I'm ready. I'm ready, dude. Are you ready? I'm ready. Thank you, Wumba. I have cleaned many undies today. Honestly, it's kind of gross, right? Like, Banjo just stuffs dirty underwear in his mouth. That's like the whole thing. All right, back to floor one. Do I not have a warp on floor two? Oh, no, I do. That was the floor two warp. The air con plant. The air is always conning me. Oh, I want that. Ah, welcome to the repair depot, which honestly is very ominous and scary. And it would, the fact that it was like closed off by like a big electric switch and they had all this like secure, all these security measures really makes this extra, extra ominous. Am I wrong? Oh, there's a Cheeto page over there too. Oh, I wonder if I can grab this Cheeto page with like a clockwork egg or something. Oh, I'm down here now. Can I activate the boss room with the Kazooie? I guess I can't. I wanna try to get it. I bet I could. If I can get one jump off. See, that's the problem. If it goes too far. No. Never mind. Uh-oh. Can't believe Banjo's dead, dude. Get ready for the second best boss in the game. Maybe the best boss. This is one of the most interesting ones. What on earth is that? I think it looks like an enormous toilet cleaner. Kinda does. Industrial plunger. Doesn't seem very mobile. See how the poor thing struggles to get in here? This shouldn't be much trouble then. He's scary, dude. For like a children's video game starring a cute bear and bird. Like, look at his sharp ass teeth. And then he jumps up and he's like, ah, shit, Weldar. Welder.
I believe it states quite clearly in the workers' guidelines that bears are not to be let into the building.
So?
Well, you're a bear, aren't you?
No.
No, I must remember to wear my glasses. Well, I'm out now, so I might as well go to work on you.
I love that. He's like, you're not... First of all, he can't see very well, which is a very, very funny... Ouch. Which is a very, very funny... Whoops. Eat that. A very funny quirk for a boss to have. Maybe he's been blinded by all the welding. That can happen, right? Like, if you don't wear a welding mask, you can easily get blinded by how bright the plasma is from the welder. Eat that! I definitely missed. The game was very generous with that hitbox. Uh-oh. Aye.
Don't make me come after you.
I do love how he heckles you the whole time, too. Don't touch me! Don't touch me! Don't. This is also one of the greatest themes in the game, too. Eat it!
This isn't going as planned. Where's my emergency switch located? That's better. Now let's see how nimble you are.
Ow. Rude. This one's absurd because he can just pull you into the electricity. Oh, no! No! Ow! It's very forceful. More.
Yee!
Man, when I was a kid, I definitely thought, like, because here's the thing, right? Like, I didn't know what a welder was when I was 7. Maybe I did, but, like, I always just, like, because he sucks on you, I always thought that he was a giant vacuum cleaner. I definitely thought he was a vacuum cleaner. And especially because, like, Kazooie says something about him being a toilet cleaner, I was like, oh, maybe she meant vacuum cleaner. Or maybe I read it as vacuum cleaner or something. Even though it clearly comes up saying that his name is Welder. Okay, wait, 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 wait for it. He's gonna drop down. He's gonna try to do a sucky. Wahey! Can I get a wahey in the comment section? Wahey!
Oh, well, looks like my welding days are over.
Looks like my sucking days are over. Poor guy. Oop. Do you want to see something like super, super fucked up about this boss? I'm gonna show you something really fucked up about this boss. Oh man, we broke the air conditioning too. That sucks. I love how they don't directly give you the jiggy. You have to go and fetch the jiggy. His head, his disembodied head is just there blinking.
I appear to be quite badly injured.
That's too bad. Now where's our prize?
I guess I can let you have this.
Is that all we get? You gotta be kidding.
You may use it to get back out. I stashed my jiggy behind the giant fan for safekeeping. But there's nothing to stop you from reaching it now. When will I learn to keep my big mouth shut?
How long do you think you could last? How long do you think you'd last after your head's been chopped off? Like, how long do you think that headless, that bodiless head is thinking? There's been some, like, research done on that. Such a fucked up thought, though, right? Oh, I think he actually says something when you go up to him, though. Hold on. I think he has additional dialogue after the fact.
I don't suppose you could recommend a decent repairman. My poor eyesight is the least of my worries now. I don't suppose you could recommend it.
Oh, yeah, okay. Is he got the two? Yeah, he's only got the two. Such a disturbing thought. All right, we've beheaded the boss. We've stopped the giant fan, which is helpful. We get a few things out of that. A couple of jiggies from stopping the air conditioning. Speaking of the air conditioning, it's getting warm in here. It is warm today. It's getting up there, man. I feel spring a-coming, you know? Still a ways off. Still a ways off. Man, you also get a Cheeto page from this boss, too. How many bosses give you a Cheeto page also? I don't think any of them, except for this one. It's kind of great. Double your prize, double your fun. It is one of the harder bosses, though, as you can tell. Like the other bosses up to this point only had one phase, I believe, right? I'm pretty sure the other bosses all had one phase. Like Old King Cole. We had, Target Zan in the first world. We had Mr. Patch. They all had one phase. Who was the boss of... Lord Wu Fak Fak technically has two phases. But the second phase really isn't much different than the first phase. Like, you're still just shooting at him. Whereas Welder at least has, like, a new attack. I think the worst that that Lord Wu Fakfak ever does is attack you faster with his eyes open. But then, like, his weak point is just, like, dead ahead, so it's a little easier to actually hit. Oh, I can't even get this yet. Dangaroni and cheese, dude. That's a big dang. That's a big dang darn right there. Can I? I wonder. I have a wonder in my brain. I was, like, really hoping. I'm gonna try it one more time. That, like, the Kazooie would spawn in long enough to grab the Jiggy, but I guess not. Yeah, we can't get that yet. We need a new move from, I believe, the next world. No, that one might not even be until the last world, so we'll have to backtrack for that. Ever so slightly annoying, but there you go. In fact, actually, I feel like that's a lot of this level. Because there's a few Jiggies, like the one that we got at in the first, like, two videos ago, where we used Kazooie to, like, flip-flap across. They expect you to get that in a different way with a different move that we don't have yet for Kazooie. So there's a few things like that in this, but... Ooh, we do have Banjo's sleep pack, snooze pack move now. So we can go back to Pterodactyl Land and get that one other Jiggy. I think it's a Jiggy. From the stomp the stomping plans. Okay, let me think. What do I want to do now? I've stopped the air conditioning. Maybe we can do... something with... Wait, what activates the fly pad? Let's see if we can get to the fourth floor at least before the end of this. See if I can remember how to get there. I think this just goes back to the second floor. We do have a battery there, which I can take into the boiler plant. I think I'll grab the one. Should I grab the one from this floor and bring it up? I'm trying to remember if there's more, like there's another one on floor two. I don't think there is. Yeah, we'll grab the one from the second floor because that one's easier to access anyway. And this one's like a little bit more out of the way.
No! Oh God, no, not my pants! Oh.
Don't you hate it when you shit your pants? It's okay to shit your pants and piss your pants sometimes. It's okay. You don't have to be afraid. Also, what are these called? Baza? What does that say on it? Hyper life? Super life? Wait, what does it say? Yeah, it's just Baza. Isn't that like an Australian kind of saying? Like people call each other Baza? Am I crazy? I'm not very familiar with Australian. I'm sure there's some Australian viewers. Baza sounds like a very Australian thing to say, though. Die. What if it's like a derogatory term, though? You Baza! Like it's like another term for bitch or something. You fucking Baza! Oh, wait, how do we get up? As Banjo. How do we get up as Banjo? I think we have to go through the vent up here. That's annoying. Maybe I should have taken the one from the third floor. I'm trying to remember if there's another battery place on the second floor here. I don't think there is. I think there's just two on the next floor up. Don't worry, I'll clean your pants one day. I'm gonna wait until we unlock all of the floors because then we can just do all the rabbits at once. Because there's like one or two that are like really well hidden. Okay, so let's take this as the boiler plant. We don't have a warp in there, do we? It might have been better for me to actually take the... Well, maybe we can just make it like this. I was gonna say, it might be better to me to take the elevator shaft up, but this works just fine. I do like a little bit of platforming in my platformer. I'm a fan of it, as you might say. Ooh, the packing room. Yo, we packing? Are you packing? I'm packing. We gotta bring Kazooie up here though. Wait, can we get Kazooie up here like easily with the springy leg? Ooh, we might be able to actually. Yoink. Shit. Nope. Okay, let's go the long way then. Enough of that. Hooray! Hooray! Man, I really wish that you... God, the move that you get for Kazooie in the next world is unmatched. And you get it so late in the game that it ends up not being that useful. And it's one that I wish I had right now. Look at this guy. Look at this wiggly little fella. Bazza! Twinkly packing challenge has been located. Game rules are available if required. No thanks. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Guys, the Twinklies are back! The Twinklies are back! Let's get as many as we can get. So here's the thing you're gonna wanna do. You're gonna wanna use Kazooie first and foremost, but notice how every time you get a fella, you get slower and slower. You're kind of weighed down. I'm not sure how many points we need because I didn't read the rules, but so long as you like stop and drop them off every so often, you're good. And I think they all weigh the same amount. I don't think that the blue ones are necessarily more heavy. Maybe they are, because they're worth more points, but I don't think that they are. So you're definitely gonna wanna grab as many of those as possible and drop them off as soon as you can, because you don't wanna run out of time. See, this is a lot more fun, I feel like, than the shooting gallery ones. It's not like super challenging or anything, but there is a multiplayer version of a lot of these games, and I think there is a multiplayer version of this one as well. And it's just like a scramble, you know? I wish that they had, oops, I didn't turn him in, but that's okay, I got him anyway. I wish that they had like a Mario Party style game, like, system, you know what I mean? Like they could have taken, could you imagine a Banjo Party where it's like Grunty's Furnace Fun and it's got like the mini games built into it from Banjo-Tooie? That would be so cool. I wonder, somebody should make a mod. Could you, oh wait, hold on. Could you imagine a mod that combines Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie so you have like the best of both worlds? Dude, I wonder if that's possible. Somebody get on it. No, I would not like to play again. That's such a cool idea that I've literally never thought of. Could you imagine that? Where like you go and you play through a bunch of Banjo-Kazooie and you ultimately unlock Banjo-Tooie within the same game. Or like maybe just like the whole world is available to you. Like one giant, it could be just one giant randomizer too. Ooh, dude. There's so much potential there. Bro, so much potential. Oh, look at that, there's a fella. What's up, fella? We'll come back for you. Did we ever find our way to the fourth floor yet? I think you can only get to the fourth floor. With the washing machine. Maybe. Oh, we'll figure it out. Oops, let's not do that. Can I make this jump? Can I make this jump? Can I make this jump? Oh, nope, nope, nope. I think there's also a Jinjo up here. It might be a Minjo, though. Are you a Minjo? Here, I'm not gonna climb all the way up there. And he's gone! Yeah, it was a Minjo. kind of beautiful, not gonna lie. Ooh, can I get up there? I think with Kazooie, I could. Yeah, I think I can only get to the fourth floor from... As the transformation. I guess we should probably do that then, huh? I feel like there's some part of this level that I'm missing. Or this floor, I should say. Well, let's go talk to Humbawamba. We'll transform and we can go ahead and do stuff with that. There's a lot of places you can't access unless you have the transformation. So, which means I'll probably start doing some of the rabbits now. There's a couple we can't get yet. They're sort of inaccessible to us. But there are a couple that we should grab. I should also go ahead and get this Jinja that's outside here while I'm thinking of it. I've already transformed though, so I'll probably forget about it. Just know that there's a Jinja on the side of this building over here that I need to climb to and I need to split up first. But we're gonna do one of these rabbits. Here we go.
The washing machine! Can you give my overalls a quick spin?
Throw them inside. We'll give it a try.
Is it safe? I don't want them to get ripped.
Just drop your shorts, buddy. We haven't got all day. Ooh. Ooh, risque. Risque.
That's better. Try and find my five skivvy workmates.
Skivvy workmates? Like skivvies? Like underwear? Underwear workmate. Wait, hold on. Yeah, she makes underwear here, so and these workers probably help in some way make underwear. What a weird concept this whole level is. I mean, the game in itself is freaking weird, but this particular level is very strange. Okay, so where's the service elevator? So one takeaway with the transformation is that you cannot use the warps. You cannot use the warps at all. So you have to use the service elevator, which is only available to the washing machine to get around. But the service elevator goes to floor 4. Notice how the icon is also a washing machine, because you have to go to the fourth floor as the washing machine to start before you can even like get here normally. There is this though. Can I push that with, yeah, I can. So with the fly pad, this is great because this will give us access to things like the fourth floor and the fifth floor and the roof access. So we can just fly around wherever we want now. Well, I guess we could also get that Jinjo. No, we can't because the door is closed. I was thinking we could fly up to that Jinjo on the side of the building, but we cannot. I wonder if... Oh, springy step shoes that we can't use. That's actually weird that that's there. I guess it's just to get back out if you need to. Access granted. You may enter. Oh, wait, this is the backside of the quality control. This is where the Jiggy appears. Okay, hold up. We gotta leave. I guess our biggest reason for coming to the fourth floor right now is to open it up so that we can get here. Right? Because I don't think we can go anywhere else. Yeah, because I can't even go up there. There's more to this floor, but we can't do anything with it. Okay, so we at least got the fly pad. Let's jump all the way up to the fifth floor. So I think there's a couple things we can do there. There's at least one other thing we can do on the... There's a warp up here too, right? Can I activate that immediately? Oh, I can't go over there. Ow, screw you. Have pants.
No.
Oh no, I want you. Let me touch you.
Heavy soil wash, if you don't mind.
So naked.
That's better. Try and find my four skivvy workmates.
Ouch. Ouch. Yeah, okay, so we also have, we can get to the fifth floor now as Banjo and Kazooie because we have the fly pad outside. So I think that's probably gonna be our next objective because there's quite a lot that we can't do on the fourth and fifth floor as the transformation now. But there is one more thing. If we go back to the second floor, no, it's the third floor. It's on the third floor. There's one more thing we can get right now. Going up.
Help.
Don't, I will not be fooled by you, Minjo. Look, it's Banjo-Kazooie nuts and bolts. And washers. That's the sequel to Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Washers. You play as the washing machine exclusively. What's up, dude?
Can we still wash if you don't mind? That's better. Try and find my three skibby workmates.
Okay. Look at how happy he is. I used to do that too. That animation, I used to try to jump and spin in place. You can imagine how difficult that is. A little easier when you're a 7-year-old kid though. Just a little bit easier. Alrighty, well that's all we can do here for now. Let's go transform again. And in the next video, I'll go ahead and use the fly pads and see if we can't access more outside the level, including the rooftop. I'm excited to go to the roof. I think that's so cool that you can just fly all the way directly to the roof. All right, y'all. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, my name is Josh Jepson. Thank you for following here on YouTube. Thank you for subscribing on Patreon. I appreciate each and every one of you, and I will see you guys in the next one.